the universe. From the moment of its creation, atoms began to combine into molecules. Molecules combined into elements, and elements into compounds, layer upon layer of matter, stacking, forever stacking. From the moment of its creation, the universe demanded that things combine to create order out of chaos. For me, a simple cat living in a brick house on a busy street, that means one thing. The universe demands that I eat more sandwiches. Hey, furries! As overblown as that opening appeared to be, I do believe that sandwiches are a universal constant. In their little delicious way, they are creating order out of chaos. Let's take the simple meatball sandwich as an example. You've got meatballs and red sauce, bread, and maybe some shredded mozzarella, depending on your taste. All of these things are edible, and you can eat them in numerous variations and in different ways. And on a table, it's chaos. You can dip the bread into the red sauce and eat the meatballs with a fork and then pinch the mozzarella cheese and put it into your mouth. Or you can dump all the mozzarella into the red sauce and mix it up, eat the meatballs with your fingers and dunk the bread into the red sauce then, etc., etc. See, it's chaos. Delicious, yummy chaos, but chaos. But to create order, to create structure out of chaos, there is one optimal pattern that you use to eat all of those ingredients at the same time. The meatball sandwich. Look at that. Just look at that. This is how those ingredients were meant to go together. That is universal harmony. That is a meatball sandwich. Now, at this point, nearly everybody thinks they have a pretty good handle on the history of the sandwich. John Montague, the Earl of Sandwich, did not want to take time away from his card game, so he ordered one of his valets to bring him cold beef between two pieces of bread, which he then proceeded to eat, and thus was created the sandwich. Now, while the story is probably true, and it definitely popularized and named the sandwich in the 18th century, beings have been sticking things between bread for a long, long time. Go figure. Something that a Northern European figured he invented was not actually invented by a Northern European. Huh. Actually, it's said that the ancient Jewish sage, Hillel the Elder, actually put lamb and herbs between two pieces of matzah during Passover. And get this. The ancient Romans used to serve a street food that was a patty of cooked meat between two pieces of bread. Yep, the Romans invented the hamburger.
Ooh.
All of this bickering about who invented what aside, the sandwich is such a simple idea, one that is built into the very fabric of reality. The idea of stacking things on top of other things to create order? Well, anybody could have invented it. Anyone and everyone could have done it. I believe that when we finally come face to face with extraterrestrial beings from across the stars, they too will have invented the sandwich. There is a central figure in the universal sandwich movement, a prophet, if you will, someone who understood the universality of the sandwich more than anyone else, earlier than anyone else. Someone whose sandwich-like superstructures have reached for the sky like an ancient Babylonian ziggurat for nearly 8 decades. Who is this amazing individual? Dagwood Bumstead from the Blondie Comics. Now, I would venture to guess that wherever you are in the world watching this right now, you are only minutes away from a sandwich. Either you have the ingredients and the fixings in your own house, or your neighbors have it and you can walk over there, or you can hop in a car and go to a gas station or a bar or a restaurant, and you'll have a sandwich. It's nothing to fear. Sandwiches represent hope. While you can fit food between two pieces of bread, if you can do that, you're alive. There's hope. Sandwiches represent hope. Now, to wrap this up, here are the 4 best sandwiches I have ever eaten. The Nabby's Trio from Nabby's in Plainfield, Illinois. Italian sausage, Italian beef, meatballs, red sauce, and cheese on a giant bun. It was a good sandwich. Moreover, it was an experience. An experience that almost killed me. It was like eating a saucy, cheesy, succulent, speeding train car. The Monte Cristo from Bennigan's. Ham, turkey, cheese, on French toast, and then batter dipped, fried, and cut into quarters. sprinkled with powdered sugar, and served with a side of raspberry jam. This is what it would be like if delicious food waged war on your body. Mind-blowingly delicious, but I am pretty sure that there are medications that I am now on that I would not need to take if I had never eaten that sandwich. Cuban sandwiches are always good, and I've tried them all over the country, including Miami, Cuba's backyard. But hands down, the best Cuban sandwich I have ever had can be found at Burritoville in DeKalb, Illinois. Roast pork, ham, white cheese, spicy bean paste, tomatoes, onions, peppers, and a sliced hot dog on Mexican bread. There is not a hangover in the world that this sandwich can't kick the crap out of. The greatest sandwich I have ever eaten, ever? That's easy. The whitefish salad sandwich from Jerry's Famous Deli in Miami on South Beach. After I ate the first one, I ordered a second. Had it wrapped up so I could take it back to the hotel with me. At the hotel, before I ate it, I wrote this letter to my lawyer.
Dear Kubler, you have always been a wonderful attorney and a dear friend. I fear, however, that my time may have grown short. The sandwich I have just eaten is nothing short of miraculous. Imagine the most wonderful chicken salad sandwich you can, but replace the chicken with succulent smoked whitefish. I have brought a second sandwich back to my hotel with me. I'm at the Lowe's Miami Beach. If this sandwich transports me to the next life, as I believe it might, please know that I am content and in no pain. Unless I choke on it, but that's something else entirely. Please, give the bulk of my estate to the kid. He'll know what to do with it. And bury me with one more of these sandwiches. They're really, really good. The sandwich, the one I have nicknamed the Pillowy Hammer of God, awaits. Farewell, my legal friend, Spigots.
I'll see you furries later. Ciao! Hey, just a real quick bit of business. I did an interview with The World According to Rich, part of the Vlogger interviews. You can check it out. I'll put the description down in the litter box, and also right here. And keep an eye out. I'll have more information, but on April 21st, I'll be in London, Ontario at a YouTube meetup with a bunch of the guys from the Quad Spot. And if you haven't seen the Quad Spot, watch it right here. So the Quad Spot and The World According to Rich. Check them out. See you soon, furries. Ciao.